May Allah help us reach these ideals. Now I would like to give the floor to Professor Dr. Ahmet Cevat Acar, Director of Istanbul Sabahattin Zaim University. The floor is yours, sir. Selamu aleyküm ve rahmetullah ve berekatü.
Sayın Başkan, değerli
Distinguished Chairman, esteemed participants, I would like to salute you all with heartfelt affection and love, and I hope that Allah will help us in our endeavors. You have 10 minutes, sir.
Şimdi efendim bu toplantının konusu daha çok adalet.
The topic of the conference is justice.
Odaklaşmış bulunuyor.
So you focused on justice as far as I have heard.
Şimdi öncelikle davet için çok teşekkür ediyorum.
First of all, I thank you for your invitation.
Türkiye'den İstanbul Kiler'in de
there are many participants attending from all around the world sharing their ideas. There are many politicians, academicians, scholars, and I would like to salute you all. Our topic, our theme is Union of Islam, and our subtopic is that is it possible to establish a common justice system or court of justice, Islamic court of justice? For the unity of Islam communities, I believe that there are some formations, some establishments. The oldest one, we have two of them, Arab League and Islamic Organization for Cooperation. And after then, other than that, we have the AIDS, which was established by Mr. Erbakan. Economic Organization for Cooperation. We have the AIDS, Developing AIDS Institution, which is composed of Islamic countries as well. And we have Nahçıvan Agreement in 2009 with the Protocol of Nahçıvan. The AIDS was established. And in 2021, Turkic states, there is another structure which was established by the Treaty of Nahçıvan. It is Turkic Council, Turkic states. The one is for the Turkish states, the other one is for the Arabic states, Arab League. And after then that, we have Islamic Organization for Cooperation. And we have Arabic Cooperation Institution. And in 1945, another establishment was constructed. This establishment was constructed. So in a nutshell, we have four institutions aiming at Islamic cooperation. And these all played a pivotal role for establishing Islamic Union.
Bunların etkinliği meselesi.
What is their effectiveness? What is the level of efficiency for these organizations? First of all, for over 2 months, we have seen the occupation of Palestine by Israel. We are facing a slaughter, a massacre, and United Nations was able to convene on the 35th day. This only shows that what is our faith in terms of collaborations and what should be done. There is a long way to go. We are just taking baby steps. Some Thermal Pisani situation we are lacking integration among the states, and justice is one of the pillars of this integration, and it is also the theme of this conference. I've touched upon the aid. If we could exclude it as it is economic cooperation, other than that, we have four institutions: Arab League, Turkic State, Islamic Organization for Cooperation. So we have three organizations that are exerting efforts for the unity of Islamic countries. So with science, with culture, there are some sub-organs and sub-committees, but for justice, they are not foreseeing any kind of cooperation. And within the scope of Islamic Organization for Cooperation, we can talk about an institute centered in Saudi Arabia. So, if we mention integration, and if we accept this phenomenon of integration, both in the Arabic states, also in the Turkic states, I would say that Arabic states and Turkic states are the most important parts of these institutions. Of course, we have Indonesia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, India. We also have Muslim population in these geographies.
Noktada ben
so my point öncelikle is that
yani elbette ki gönlümüzden geçen
of course we have our feelings, heartfelt feelings, and we are aiming at bigger picture, but objectively, what is our current situation? We need to have the analysis first. What are our weak areas, and what are our advantages and disadvantages, and what are our circumstances? How can we improve our collaboration? Let's start with the justice. Our integration is not in the desired level in the other areas, so we cannot even mention integrity or unity in justice. Before everything, there are some weaknesses, there are some adverse effects. First of all, there are vital issues among the modern countries, like foreign relations, international relations, economic relations. And we need to cooperate in these fields. These are very crucial areas. And we are not in the desired level. And if we cannot, if we fail to accomplish the desired levels, then I think that justice, cooperation, and integration of justice is far away from us now. And there is a long way to go. First of all, there are some certain differences among the Muslims, and we couldn't find any satisfying response how to establish a basis that we could all come together. So, in the level of countries and in the level of UMMA, we are not good to evaluate our differences as our richness. So, what should be the perspective? What should be the understanding? There are different common law. There are different facts. So, on a common basis, on a common ground, we should see our differences as our richness, as opportunities. Unfortunately, we fail to do so until now. And Arab League, there are 22 countries within the scope of Arab League. And when civil war started in Syria, Syria was excluded from Arab League, and I think that Syria will be back to the Arab League soon. So in Turkish Union, Turkish Council, Turkmenistan is an observer. Next year, maybe Turkmenistan will be a member as well. So, everyone has an imagination. Everything should be based on imagination, but we should take account of reality. Please don't despair from what I say. We should, of course, increase our cooperation. Of course, we should have scientific meetings. There are some mottos, there are some words, but still, we need to see the realities. We cannot live in the world of hope or dream. So,
İnsanlık dışı ve Müslümanların dışında
sometimes sağlayabilecek konularda bile bir eylem there are inhuman activities against a Muslim community and we cannot do anything as the Muslim countries now. I don't want you to despair, but I would like you to show the seriousness of the job that we should do. Not only in Palestine, in East Turkmenistan, in Myanmar, there is a massacre, there is a pressure, there is an oppression against Muslim people. And in Gaza, what is happening is really vital, and we couldn't take any concrete steps until now, as the Islamic countries, we haven't made any significant contribution. Well, I will wrap it up now. What I would like to emphasize is that there are Turkic states, Turkic states, there are Arabic states, and as the umbrella organization, Islamic Union, we have all institutions, organizations, all together. Of course, we need to debate, we need to exchange our views, and we should work on that, and it is our obligation, it is a necessity, but please, while we are doing that, please look at our current position, our current conditions. Please take all of them into consideration. We need to follow all the developments, and I believe that in order to ensure integration and justice, we need to complete integration in other areas. There is a new postmodern war right now, And I believe that there is an abuse of differences, and this is the fundamental strategy adopted so far. We should not abuse our differences, and they are trying to destabilize the Muslim countries, and we see some proxies, and they are using them as puppets. And we see different methods, and it is like a hybrid war. To sum up, at Muslim people, at national level, at global level, we should embrace our differences as our richness, and we should preserve our common values. And while doing this, we need to speak ways for our unity. It is not possible for us to change the world now. We don't have the necessary power for that. But we should at least urge United Nations for a favored decision. As our President Mr. Recep Tayyip Erdogan underlined, the world is bigger than five, so we should at least facilitate and strengthen the role of the United Nations for the benefits of Muslim countries. While ending my verse, I've just learned our Adnan Pasha is sick, and I hope he will recover very soon. And once again, I would like to extend my condolences for our martyrs who fell in Gaza. And once again, I wish patience to their families.